Rice provides food to roughly 3 billion people of this planet. It is the staple food for people in Asia and increasingly so for people in Africa and the rest of the world. And it's grown by nearly 150 million smallholder farmers on something like 170 million hectares of land. So it's a huge commodity. Nevertheless, it also, in the rice sector, we have nearly 1 billion people still daily affected by hunger and poverty. So if we can make improvements in the way farmers can grow rice, help them get more income, produce more rice of better quality, we can have huge impacts on food security and poverty of the population at large. Now, most of the rice is being produced by farmers in Asia. And exciting things are happening at the moment in Asia. They're labeled all under a term called structural transformation. And that means that the rural society is getting more and more integrated in the urban one. We see farmers migrating and rural laborers migrating out of the countryside to the cities. This means that there is less labor available to do the work on the farm. We have labor shortage. Labor price goes up. We see feminization of the labor force. So we have these questions. Who will actually grow the rice that we need in the future to feed a still increasing population, by the way? We also see that consumers in the cities, when they get a bit more affluent, they have more demands on the quality of rice. So farmers not only need to be aware of or conscious of that they need to produce more rice, it also needs to be of better quality, more nutritious, healthier. And at the same time, these farmers are faced with increasing scarcity of water, labor, land resources. So we need to develop new technologies, policies, to help these farmers basically do a better job. Now, we can see this structural transformation as a threatening, but it also offers us huge opportunities, actually. So we have launched within the RICE program, CRIS program, a 5-point action plan to help lift people, small farmers especially, out of poverty and help with food security. The first of these is intensification. If we can get more yield, more production from 1 hectare of rice land, we will make a significant impact on total rice production and food security. We can do that by developing and disseminating new and improved varieties, which have a higher nutritious content, which can deal with water scarcity, with the increasing impacts of climate change, such as drought and flooding. We can also improve management practices tremendously, water management, nutrient management, integrated pest management. Second, we should help farmers cope with labor scarcity. Obvious solutions, mechanization. Mechanization has a number of additional benefits. It tremendously increases the labor productivity of the farmer. That means that the farmer who is left behind on the farm, who does not migrate to the cities, gets a better income and a better return to his labor. Direct contribution to his own poverty alleviation. But mechanization also contributes to better crop management. It contributes to higher yield. So there is this double-edged sword, higher productivity and higher returns to own labor. The third proposition that we have revolves around helping farmers increase their farm size. As more and more farmers move out of the farmlands into the cities, we have less farmers. Right now in Asia, farmers have access to maybe 1 to 2 hectares. Even if you double productivity and yield, that farmer is still a smallholder farmer and will not get really out of poverty. But if we can help that farmer get a larger farm, 5 hectares, maybe 10 hectares, through land consolidation, then all of a sudden we get skill increase, we get increased opportunities for mechanization, we can get increased opportunity for efficiency gain. So land consolidation and scale increase is the third highlight of our 5-point plan. The fourth one is actually help to transform a smallholder farmer who is mostly a subsistence farmer right now to an entrepreneurial farmer. Help her, help him acquire new skills, new marketing skills specifically, new negotiation skills, new skills to maybe participate in the whole value chain by investing maybe in half in milling or in processing or trading. And that brings me to the fifth spear point of a 5-point action plan, strengthening the whole value chain. Increasingly, we see through that process of structural transformation that businesses get involved, and we see, for example, what's been called the supermarket revolution, where supermarkets and markets directly start to interact with farmers to source their rice from farmers. We also see an increase in the professionalization of millers and traders. Farmers could exploit these developments in the whole rice value chain if we connect them better, if we improve again their negotiation skills. So altogether, this 5-point action plan on intensification, on mechanization, on consolidation, on training, capacity building of the farmer in terms of turning him or her more into an entrepreneur, and value chain strengthening, the fifth one. The investments that the CRISP program is making with all of its 900 partners through this 5-point action plan, we believe can have a tremendous impact on poverty and food security. We expect that over the next 5-10 years, we can help lift 15 million poor people out of poverty and out of hunger. We expect that we can help 8 million rice eaters have access to healthy and nutritious rice, help lift 8 million rice consumers out of malnutrition. We think we can make tremendous contribution to a more sustainable and a cleaner environment. So this is what CRISP and its 900 partners have bought into, and this is what we commit to help alleviate poverty and food insecurity in the next 10 years.